incidents, today I want to give you the circle exercise, which is great for smooth bowing and an even sound on the violin. Here's how it goes. You imagine a big circle in which you can move your bow. And then you integrate a whole bow stroke into this circle movement. Mind that your bow doesn't have to make the circle, but mainly your hand makes the circle. So this. And mind that you have a good bow hold with nicely curved fingers. So you're not holding the bow like this. Then draw a circle in the air and land the bow at the frog. Make a whole bow stroke. But you'll see that this whole bow stroke is part of the circle. So what the bow does is that you first have a little bit this. So on the D string, you're inclining towards the A string. A little bit this, if I do it exaggerated. And then during the bow stroke, you actually lift everything. So you are more inclining to the G string. Make sure you land a bow without scratching or jumping the bow, but really make a smooth landing like an airplane and then lift off again. Now what happens is that at the frog you will have relatively little bow weight, so you don't get scratchy sounds at the frog very quickly. And then as you move to the tip where the bow is naturally lighter, you lift your arm a bit and you have more supination and more weight transfer on the bow. So you have more weight at the tip. And that not only makes your bowing smoother, but you also get a more even sound. Because if I don't change the bow pressure or the bow weight as it should be, then usually I sound louder at the frog and softer at the tip or the upper half. Here it is without a circle. Then you hear a decrescendo on the down bow. If I do it with a circle, then I can create an even sound. Now, same goes for the up bow. So also practice the circle in the other direction and then land the bow at the tip. That can be a little bit difficult. And then make an up bow. Now, if this exercise is a little bit difficult for you, you need quite some finger flexibility and strength for it, then what you might practice is just landing the bow at the frog and making little circles where you really engage this finger movement. If that's too hard for you, then do it at the balance point of the bow. Now, then practice landing at the tip and doing an up bow. And you might need some more attention to landing at the tip, and you might put some weight through your index finger in the bow, because otherwise it starts with the bounce, because the bow really wants to bounce there. So keep the bow under control, and as soon as the bow lands at the tip, you give a little bit weight with the index finger. At a frog, you don't need it. If you do that, you might even get a scratch. So the technique for landing at the frog and landing at the tip is different. So you might practice these two things separately. Now we did long bow strokes, and you can imagine that the shorter the bow stroke, the smaller the circle. So if I do half bow, then it's also a little bit easier. So you might want to start with the smaller circles and then build it up from there if you find it difficult. You can imagine that something like spiccato is also half of a circle, of a very small circle. And that's exactly why it's so useful if you want to practice spiccato to also do collet movements at the frog and really make those circles. And then remember those circles if you move to the semi-passive bowing technique that spiccato is. I hope this circle exercise will help you with smooth bowing and a good even tone. And if you want to know more about the mechanics of smooth bowing, you might also want to watch this video about the 3-8 movements you have while bowing. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to catch you in one of my other video lessons. Bye!